Five bonkers Christmas movies to watch this holiday season. This is Nerdist Now. It's that time of year again. The holidays are upon us, which means you're probably going crazy shopping for presents, figuring out ways to travel safely, and how to avoid people from high school when you're at that one bar in your hometown that everyone goes to. It's impossible. One way to keep yourself level, aside from slipping into a nog hole as soon as the sun sets at 4 p.m., is to unwind with some Christmas movies. Specifically, ones that make you realize that the stress of the holidays can be way worse. We've assembled five bonkers and somewhat obscure films for you to lose yourself in while you're trying to figure out why your mom owns so many f***ing nutcrackers. Rare exports. The country of Finland has given us many things. Saunas, Nokia phones, the first internet browser, and the 2010 holiday horror film, Rare Exports. In the movie, a British drilling team bores into a nearby mountain near the home of two boys in northern Finland. The boys believe the team has uncovered the tomb of Santa Claus himself. He's some kind of Dracula Santa, a Santula, if you will. Or a Dracta Claus? Either one. The boys turn out to be right, but the Santa they get isn't nearly as nice as your run-of-the-mill mall Santa. In fact, he's downright horrifying. If you're a fan of other creepy Christmas movies like Krampus and Gremlins, then Rare Exports is definitely up your alley. Or down your chimney in this instance. Ho ho ho. Invasion USA. We've thankfully moved beyond Chuck Norris jokes as a society, but his 1985 action movie Invasion USA ages like a fine mulled wine, with a decorative grenade tossed in. Norris plays retired CIA agent Matt Hunter, who is brought back into action when an army of Russian terrorists storms southern Florida to get revenge and cause destruction. This is one of those movies where Norris plays an invulnerable murder machine, similar to movies like Commando or Rambo 2. I'm pretty sure he also reverses time at one point so a homemade bomb doesn't explode in his hands. There's plenty of over-the-top explosions, shootouts, tanks driving through houses, terrible Russian accents, and enough tinsel to stretch all the way from Gainesville to Key West. Is that a long way? I don't know Florida geography. Santa with muscles! So at the very top of this list, we said these movies were bonkers. We made no guarantees of the quality of the films, but if you're one of those cinephiles who loves trash, then look no further than the 1996 movie Santa with Muscles, starring famed pasta chef Hulk Hogan and a very young Mila Kunis. Hulk Hogan plays an evil millionaire named Blake Thorne who ends up getting amnesia through a comedy of errors and Clint Howard, and then is convinced he's Santa Claus by a mall elf, and chaos ensues. Meanwhile, Ed Begley Jr. is playing an evil scientist who is trying to take over an orphanage because, and I kid you not, it has magic crystals underneath it. Is this movie good? No. Is it so bad it's good? Kinda? Did it get pulled out of theaters after only 2 weeks because it was bombing so hard? Yes, yes it did. I know it sounds like a terrible time, but if you're looking for something so weird it borders on outsider art, then cram this in your VCR. And also, get a VCR. Santa Claus versus the Devil. Okay, what is happening now? This next film you might know if you're an MST3K fan, but if you're not, the 1959 Mexican film Santa Claus versus the Devil is a fever dream wrapped inside an even creepier fever dream. The plot of the movie is pretty simple. A demon is sent to Earth to try to convince kids to do minor vandalism. You know, the devil's work. And it's up to Santa to stop him from his command center. However, in this universe, Santa doesn't reside at the North Pole. Instead, he lives in a castle fortress that's floating in outer space. And he keeps tabs on what's going on Earth thanks to his nightmare supercomputer and telescope. I don't know why you'd ever need to prove this, but if someone ever says that robots should have lips, show them this movie. Also, the Roman god Vulcan lives with him and gives him keys to access everyone's homes. The reindeer are robotic for some reason. Oh, and Merlin is there too. No clue how he got there. It's kind of the perfect movie to put on if you're wrapping presents at 3 a.m. and want to descend fully into madness. Deadly Games. Deadly Games, also known as Dial Code Santa Claus, Game Over, Hide and Freak, or my personal favorite, 3615 Code Père Noël, is a French action thriller from 1989 that could possibly be the precursor to Home Alone. No joke, this movie just absolutely rules. Thomas, a child prodigy obsessed with action movies, lives in a super high-tech mansion with his mother, his very frail grandfather, and his dog JR. I don't want to give too much away, but I'll pitch you the movie like this. Imagine if you were a kid, planning to catch Santa Claus when he comes down your chimney. But the Santa that shows up is a psychopathic killer, and you have to fight him off while keeping your cartoonishly fragile grandpa safe. Throw in booby traps that make Kevin McAllister look like a pacifist, and you've got Deadly Games. It's the absolute perfect addition to your Christmas action movie marathon. If you want some recommendations of holiday action movies that aren't Die Hard, you should check out our list from last year. But tell us, what weird Christmas movies are your favorites? Are there any you think we missed? Is Merlin a prisoner in Santa's space castle? Please, just somebody tell me if he's safe. Let us know in the comments below, and for the latest and greatest in the world of pop culture, stay tuned to Nerdist.com.